Hello friends, I am Amoghi M, working as assistant professor in English in GFGCW Chikparapur. And today I am going to talk about analysis of the poem The Beaver Bird. In the last session, that is session number 10, which comes in the BA General English 4th sem, I explained about the poet that is Kofi Annan. The poem The Beaver Bird has been written by the poet called Kofi Annan, and in the last video I discussed at length about Kofi Annan, about his life, about his career as a poet, what he has incorporated in his poems, all those things in the last video I discussed at length. And now we can look at the poem The Beaver Bird. So let us start looking at the poem. Let us try to analyze the poem now. So let us look at the analysis of the poem. The Beaver Bird, the poem, is a post-colonial poem by Kofi Annan. It utilizes symbol of the beaver bird to represent the coming of the colonists to Africa. The language is very simple and effective in conveying a deeper meaning. So let us try to analyze each point in detail. The Beaver Bird is a post-colonial poem by Kofi Annan. What do you mean by post-colonial poem? The poem which has been written by non-European people about their country. So first of all, let's try to understand what do you mean by post-colonialism. First, Britishers, as you know, they went everywhere and made every country as their colonies. During 15th or during 16th and 17th century, they were at the peak, or should I say 17th and 18th century, they were at the peak. They were like they were the strongest, and they went everywhere and made every country as their slave. Means they made every country as their own. They started ruling these countries. England is a very small country. Actually, the population is very less, but still, in those days they had very strong army, very clever people as the heads of armies, and they used some tactics to get into each country and started ruling them. So similarly, they went to Africa and made every country as colony. So after some time, what happened, actually after the Second World War, the Second World War ended in 1945, and you know, Britishers or Britain was in the they were the winners, they were the joint winners. Still, though they won the World War, this led to their colonies to revolt against them. They almost every colony of British started freedom movements, and we all know even India was their colony. In India they ruled for almost 190 years. The Plassey War could be regarded as the beginning of British rule in India. It happened in the year 1757, and then they ruled up to 1947. So almost for 190 years they ruled in India. Then the freedom movement started with the revolt of 1857, and for 90 years it went on, and finally Britishers gave freedom to us and we became independent. India became independent in the year 1947. So similarly, in Africa also many countries started their freedom struggles, and in the same way they gave freedom to India, they also give freedom to the countries of Africa and went away from there. And now I would like to come to post-colonial period. So this period, post-colonial period, is the country post-colonial, post-colonies or post-colonial period is a period which in which the country which was the colony of British till very recently and got independence, and it is still living in the shadow of the colonists or Britishers. And in the same way, this poem is a post-colonial poem. So who writes a post-colonial poem? The post-colonial poem is written by a non-European person, and he writes about the country which got independence recently from Britishers. And it also, in the poem, the post-colonial poem, the poet writes about how the country is feeling after getting independence, how the country is feeling, whether it is still in the influence of the Britishers, whether the country is still following the rules, whether the culture of Britishers. So that is a brief introduction of post-colonial poem. So now I can safely say that you understood the concept of post-colonial poem. So the Weaver Bird is a post-colonial poem, and now it utilizes the symbol of the Weaver Bird to represent the coming of the colonists to Africa. So the symbol of Weaver Bird. So in the last video, I told you that this Kofi Annan uses lots of symbolism while writing his poetry, and in this poem he has used the weaver bird as a symbol of Britishers. It symbolizes colonization, it symbolizes the coming of Britishers to Africa. So in the poem, the Weaver Bird is a symbol of the coming of Britishers or the coming of the colonizers to Africa. And now let us look at the language. The language of the poem is very, very simple, and at the same time very, very effective also. It conveys a very, very deeper meaning. Means it provides very deeper meaning. The poem is not just about superficial meaning. It gives a very deep meaning. So this is about the poem. Now the analysis of the poem continues. The poem contains some phrases like "and laid its eggs on our only tree, old shrines defiled by the weaver's excrement," to show how the colonizers came to establish itself on the African continent. The phrases also indicate invasion of the colonizers and the predicament of the colonized. So the poem contains some phrases, that is, "and laid its eggs on our only tree." Here, eggs and tree represents some meaning. In the next video, while I would be talking about the metaphors of the poem, I will explain. So, old shrines defiled by the weaver's excrement. To show, and these two phrases show how colonizers, how Britishers came to Africa and established themselves on the African continent. They were the foreigners. They came to Africa as traders. They came to African continent as traders. Then what happened? They started interfering in the administration of African continent. Then later what happened, they started taking control and finally they became the rulers. You might be feeling that the same story has been heard previously. This story goes very similar to India also. To India also they came as traders, then slowly they started interfering in the administration of Indian rulers. And then because of the inability of Indian rulers, they started gaining control over India. And after the war of Plassey in 1757, they took the control of India and they became rulers. So they used the same method in India as well as Africa. In fact, they used this strategy everywhere. First, they went as traders or as visitors or as tourists. Then they started, first they controlled the business there, and then they started interfering in administration of the country, and later they took the control, and then finally they become rulers. This is a pattern of Britishers in that period. And now the phrases also indicate invasion of colonizers and the predicament of the colonized. So the phrases, that is, and laid its eggs on our own tree. So, and old shrines defiled by the viewer's excrement, that is waste. So these phrases indicate invasion of the colonizers. Invasion means how they attacked our country. So Unur is talking about Africa, how Britishers attacked their continent and they established their rule. Predicament, it also talks about predicament of colonized. Predicament means the difficulties the colonized people, the native people, faced due to the rule of Britishers. So again, this poem is a criticism of Britishers' colonial policy. So the poet laments that native people of Africa were left with nothing. A tone of bitterness and anger is brought out by the use of the word excrement. It shows how the Africans do not consider the ways forced on them by the West as superior. So here the poet laments. He feels very bad. Lament means feel bad. He feels very bad. He feels pain. Bad or pain. So the word lament means pain, to be exact, pain, or it can be also used for pain. So the poet feels the pain and he also feels bad that native people of Africa did not have anything. What these Britishers did was they came to Africa as well as India. They came to Africa as well as India as traders. So in the case of India, what happened was they came as traders, they came here, they established their business, and then after some time they started interfering in the administration of the Indian rulers, and then after some time they started gaining control, and later finally they became the rulers. So they used similar methodology in Africa also. They went there as traders. After establishing their business, they started interfering in the administration of local African leaders, and then they started gaining control over the African continent, and finally they became the rulers. And what it had a very harmful effect on the people of Africa. What it made is that African people were left with nothing. They didn't have anything. The country was theirs. The resources were theirs, and everything was theirs. But they cannot claim anything. Everything is under the control of these Britishers. So this made the poet very sad. So what he says that he feels very sad for the African people because they don't have anything with them. And one could see a tone of bitterness and anger. So bitterness means pain again, pain and anger. So a tone of bitterness and anger is brought out by the use of the word excrement. So one could feel the pain. While reading the poem, one could feel the pain and anger. If you read the poem, you can feel the pain with which the poet has written the lines. In the lines, one can feel the pain and angry, and anger of the poet. So he lets out the pain and the anger of the poet comes out with the word excrement. Excrement means waste. So in other words, he's comparing the colonizers, that is Britishers, as waste. And the word also reflects on how Africans think about the colonizers. So according to the poet, the Africans don't consider the ways forced on them by the West as superior. So there is a belief. There's the belief that West is very superior compared to other parts of the world. West means Europe and England are the best, and the rest of the world is not that good. So the poet says it is not, this belief is not right. So he doesn't, especially Africans don't think that they are not good. They believe that they are the best. So they don't consider that West is superior. That's what the poet is trying to say here. Now, revision. Weaver Bird is a post-colonial poem. I already explained you what do you mean by post-colonial poem. It utilizes the symbol of Weaver Bird to represent the coming of colonists to Africa, and it laid eggs on our only tree, old shrines defiled by the weaver's excrement. These are the key phrases of the poem. So these two phrases are very, very important. Both the phrases define how the state of Africa, how Africa has been captured by the colonizers, how colonizers came and established themselves, and then they started ruling the continent. And one could see the bitterness and the anger, in the tone of the poet as he uses the word for the phrase excrement. So the phrase excrement showcases or reflects the pain and anger of the poet which he has on the Britishers or the colonizers. So with this, the analysis of the poem, the first part of the analysis of the poem is done. In the next video, we will be looking at metaphors. Metaphors used in the poem, The Weaver Bird. For now, I would like to take your leave. Thank you.